I would like to know how effective is the PRP therapy on hair fall thinning?
Thank you for your question. You've asked a question where you want to know how effective is PRP therapy for hair fall or hair thinning. Well, I can definitely help you with this question. I'm a board-certified cosmetic surgeon, certified by the American Board of Cosmetic Surgery, and fellowship-trained oculofacial plastic surgeon, practicing in Manhattan and Long Island for 20 years. I'm also the founder of Trichostem Hair Regeneration Centers, and have been very active in the technology of the use of PRP as an alternative for hair loss. So I'll give you my personal experience, and in no way does this intend to disparage other physicians. To understand hair loss, you have to begin with essentially the most common cause of hair loss, which is male or female pattern hair loss, or genetic hair loss, hair thinning. The drugs that are currently available in the United States are minoxidil and finasteride. And without going into detail of that therapy, we're going to discuss a little bit about the alternative therapies. For many years, it was observed when you injected the scalp with platelet-rich plasma, it appeared to stimulate hair growth. So there's no question that there is some effect on the scalp on hair growth with platelet-rich plasma. What we've developed in our practice is a technology using platelet-rich plasma called hair regeneration. Hair regeneration is combining platelet-rich plasma with extracellular matrix. Extracellular matrix is derived from a tissue that is intended, its intended use is for wound healing. Well, it happened to be the case that a side effect of the wound healing benefit of extracellular matrix when used during hair transplant appeared to be hair thickening. So what we observed was that although PRP can stimulate hair growth, it doesn't stop hair loss or hair thinning. So you could technically keep getting PRP injections, but you won't stop the hair from falling out eventually. With hair regeneration, what we've developed is a formulation and a method to deliver this combination so that hair loss stops. And not only does the progression stop, but thinning hairs actually become thicker. So it's actually a reversal of the thinning process. Now, it doesn't work 100% to the point where you get back all your hair, but it does work very effectively for more than 99% of male pattern hair loss patients that we've treated, and we've treated people who are coming from around the world, and we have two offices in New York, and one in Garden City, Long Island, and one in Manhattan, and we have centers that we are setting up outside of this area, and we're seeing consistently great results with this treatment. The key is, of course, is that the earlier we catch somebody, the better it is. Now, there are going to be people that it doesn't work on. There are going to be people that who still lose hair in spite of the intervention. But with male pattern hair loss, our statistics do hold up that 99% of the patients we treat do respond and do very well. We even do additional injections based on a customized monitoring and approach that will even further improve the results. So I think that the answer to the question is that PRP doesn't stop hair loss. It can, in some ways comparable to the effect of Rogaine or minoxidil, cause hair to appear a little thicker because it can short-term stimulate hair growth. We have seen many patients who have had PRP injections performed by doctors in other facilities, and they'll say that they they went and got the injection every month. And interestingly, there was no documentation as to the benefit. So I think a lot of people who do perform it feel like they're trying to do something to help their patients, but understand that it does have its limitations. So from my perspective, we would not use PRP alone for hair loss. We use it in combination with our method called hair regeneration. So I think that you should investigate this methodology and this technology, because this world of regenerative medicine and this wound healing technology has actually become such a game changer for us in our practice, where we used to do a lot of hair transplants because the majority of men who came for consultation for transplant were men who have thinning hair. It wasn't bald men, it was men with thinning hair. Well, we see people with thinning hair and we treat them with hair regeneration. We actually found that we get better results with salvaging and thickening existing thinning hair than we would by doing a transplant. And that, of course, there are going to be exceptions, but there, as a general rule, based on a certain level of density of existing hair, the results can be quite impressive. Because once you stop the progression of hair loss, if those hairs got to be thicker, then it appears that the majority of our patients find that they end up in a place where they were comfortable. And it makes a lot of sense, because if you could bring them back to where they were a few years ago, then most of the time they're pretty satisfied with that result. So I hope that was helpful. I wish you the best of luck, and thank you for your question.